Hello, welcome to our channel for probability and statistics. In this video, we will talk about normal distribution. Normal distribution is the most important continuous probability distribution in statistics, and it is also called Gaussian distribution. Its graph, called the normal curve, is a bell-shaped curve. This is the density of normal distribution. Normal distribution is widely used because it can describe many phenomena in nature, industry, and research. For example, physical measurements in an area such as meteorological experiments and rainfall studies and many other phenomena. And the limiting distribution of many other distribution, so average, or many other kinds of random variables, average, sample, mean, can be modeled as a normal distribution. So normal distribution is a continuous distribution, and its random variable have a bell-shaped figure. So these two are normal distributions, density curve, these two also, and these two. And its density function called n x mu sigma has two parameters. One is the mean mu, and another is standard deviation sigma. We use variance sigma square. So in the normal distribution's density function, its density is 1 divided by square root of 2 pi, then times sigma. This part in the denominator, then times the power of e. In the power part is the minus 1 divided by 2 sigma square, then times x minus mu take a square. And the available variable for normal distribution can be from negative infinity to the positive infinity real number. Some properties of the normal density curve. The first, it's a mode. The mode is the point which for the values occur most frequently in all available values. So here is the mean, and the mean is also the mode because this value occurs much higher than any other values in normal density. So mean is also the mode in normal distributions curve. And the normal distribution is symmetric, no skew, which means no skew. And for values between mu minus sigma, so here, and mu plus sigma in this range, the curve is concave downwards, or say convex upwards. And for the value range less than mu minus sigma and mu plus 1 sigma, for this area and this area, the curve is convex downward or concave upward. A normal curve approaches the horizontal axis asymptotically as we proceed in either direction away from the mean. So usually outside of mu minus 3 sigma, so its density is very low, approaches to zero. And the total area under the curve, for the area, this area is 1. Well, this applies for any other continuous density, right? So the curve, density curve for any continuous probability distribution is constructed so that the area under the curve bounded by two ordinates, x1 and x2, will equal the probability that the random variable x assumes a value between x1 and x2. So x1 and x2, this area shaded area represents the probability for random variable x between x1 and x2. So for normal distribution, this part of the probability can be calculated with the integral of normal density function over dx and with the lower bound x1 to upper bound x2. So there are many types of statistical software that can be used in calculating areas under the normal curve, so calculating the probabilities. The difficulty encountered in solving integrals of normal density function also necessitates the tabulation of normal curves and area for quick reference. So sometimes you can use normal table to find the probability manually. So for this purpose, usually we will transform a random normal variable into a new set of observations of a normal or called a standard normal random variable called Z with mean 0 and 1. So Z, if we minus the mu from random variable X which is normally distributed, then divided by its sigma, then this transformations will get a variable called Z. So this is a standard normal distribution variable with mean 0 and variance 1. And from this Z can find directly from the normal distributions table probabilities. So if X falls between the value X1 and X2, so the random variable Z will fall between Z1 and Z2. Z1 and Z2 equal X1 minus mu divided by sigma and X2 minus mu divided by sigma, right? And consequently, if we calculate the probability of X between X1 and X2, it would equal to the probability of Z between Z1 and Z2. So this form is the standard normal distribution density function. The E is the power is minus 1 of 2 times Z squared. So from normal distributions table, this applies to Z value. So from here, for example, Z equals 0.5. Then we, from the column, we'll find, for example, 8. So which means 0.58. This one, the value is 0.7190. What this mean? This means the cumulative probability up to this Z value in normal density curve. So this is a normal density curve for the Z value, which is a standard normal distribution with mean 0 and standard deviation 1. So we find a Z value, this value also called a quantile value or random variable or normal random variable, it's the same meaning. So if we find this Z value here, there is 0.58. So this shaded area is cumulative probability of all the value less than or equal to this Z value. So this Z value is a quantile, this area also called a quantile probability. So here we find the value is 0.7190, which means this area is 7190. So from different Z value, we can find a different cumulative probability. Then we can get the difference between these two Z value, can get the shaded area between these two value, right? So we will show more examples later. So first example is, given a standard normal distribution, find the area under the curve such lies the question A to the right of Z equals 1.84. And question B, find the area under the curve such lies between Z equals minus 1.97 and Z equals 0.86. So the solution is the area in figure A. The solution for A is to find the area in figure A to the right of the equals 1.84. Right of the F say equals 1.84. This probability is equal to 1 minus the area in table to the left of Z, right? So we just, if we want to find this shaded area, just use 1 minus this white area. White area is the left part of Z, right? So, and the left of Z equals 0.86 can find about 0.9617 well from the table. So the shaded area is 1 minus this part, which equals 0.0329. And for the question B, the area between say 1 minus 1.97 and say equals say 2 is 0.86 is equal to the area to the left of say equals 0.86, or the cumulative probability to the quantile 0.86 minus the quantile minus the cumulative probability of say equal to 1.97. So this is the difference, and this shaded area is what we want. So it's about 0.7807. Example 2. Given a standard normal distribution, find the value of k such that probability say larger than k equals 0.3015. And the question B is find the k, then probability of say between k and minus 0.18 is 0.4197. So example 2 is different from example 1, actually it's the opposite case. So we want to find, here we want to find the key value, also the random value, right? From the given probability. So for the solution A, in figure A, can see that the key value leaving an area of 0.3015 to the right must leave an area of 0.6985 to the left. So white area is 0.6985, right? And from the table, from the table, we can also find a value from the table, then back to find the Z value, right? So you can from the Z value find the value for the cumulative probability, or you can find from given cumulative probability in this area to get the Z value. So this is what we will do in example 2. So from the 0.6095 in this white area, this is the cumulative probability up to k. So we can find the k is 0.52. This is what we want. And question B can also from the table can find the total area to the left of 0.18 is equal to 4286. 0.18 for find this area, 0.4286. In figure B, we see that the area between k and 0.18 is 0.4197. So which means that this small white area is about 0.0089. So again, from the table, we can find that the k equals minus 2.37. You can see in the normal distribution, standard normal distribution, when the value is minus 2.37, its area to the left, its cumulative probability is quite low. It's very, very little, right? Close to zero. The third example, Given a random value x having a normal distribution with mu 50, sigma 10, find the probability that x assumes a value between 45 and 62. So here, in this example, the value are not a standard normal distribution, right? The mu is 50, sigma is 10. So, but we only from the table can know the standard normal distribution's probability. So we have to transform this random variable into a z value first, right? So the z1 is 45 minus the mu divided by sigma, and about minus 0.5, and z2 can also get a value 1.2. Then the probability of x between these two values equals the probability of z between these two values. So using the table, we can find the probability is about 0.5764 between these two values, right? And sometimes we are required to find the value of x corresponding to a specified probability that falls between the values listed in the table. So we see an example, which is also the opposite case for example 3. So given a normal distribution with mu 40 and sigma 6, find the value of x that has a 45% of the area to the left and b 14% of the area to the right. So such kind of problem, we first have to find the z value from the table. So for the question A, because the z value minus 0.13 has a cumulative probability of 0.45. So the desired z value is minus 0.13. So we can get the x value, which is not a standard normal distribution. We can use sigma times this z value, then plus the mean. Sigma 6, mu is 40, right? Because the z value equals x minus mu divided by sigma. So x equals z value times sigma plus mu, right? This is opposite case for the z value transformation. So now we get x from the z now. Z value times sigma, then plus mu. So x equals 39.22. And for the question B, we can find z less than the probability of z less than 1.08 is 0.86. Right? To the right. So because 14% of the area to the right, so which means 0.86 to the area to the left. Of course, from the standard normal distribution table, we only list the cumulative probability to the left of z. So we must first get to the left of z. So left of z is 0.86 probability. So which means z is 1.08. Can check from the table to get this z value from the 0.86, right? So z value is 1.08. So the desired x value is also this z value times sigma, then plus the mu. So x equals 46.48 is what we want. Thanks for watching.